Oh shit, look at all this stuff. Oh my god. Maybe I should have built those, the gateways. I should have built them more behind due to the fact that we might get owned here. No, Mohander!
Forgive me, great Tassadar. I wasn't strong enough.
Oh. Okay, so as you can see, we're back to the game, and it's a little different this time. I preemptively set up the base up here, so definitely if you're playing, like, hard or brutal mode, you're going to want to do this prior, because this is going to make it way easier, I think. It's like no way that you should be doing anything else in regards to building your base. I mean, you do have to sacrifice some structures, probably. But, yeah, it's worth it in terms of actually surviving, so you might as well do it. Now, what we have here is a lot of these units. Wow, they take, like, no damage. You're gonna want to make sure that still... I mean, I guess you can kind of try and make everyone survive. But, I mean, needless to say, like, you're not going to be able to... You might be able to survive all the way. Actually, if you preemptively defend, like I am right now, you'll be able to survive the last wave without a hitch, probably. Like, there's no reason you should really die here if you're doing what I'm doing. Like, as you can see, I canned up, put some gateways in the front, so those big creatures... those hybrid reavers can't just like walk through. And I pretty much worked on my air army a little bit. Not really. My army is pretty much the same. Lots of stalkers. Keep getting Phoenix once in a while. Because the Phoenix really helped for those things. But yeah, now it's really quiet. Still have 500 to go. And should not be a problem. Now what might be a problem is when a lot of those... air units come, what do you call it, broodlords? That can create an issue. As long as you have a lot of Phoenix though, these big things shouldn't be too much of a problem. I mean, you can like really focus them down when they're in the air, because they're like a big huge target. But, yeah. That's how it is. It's always good to focus them down too, since they are pretty much the prime target you're going to want to go for. Now, another way to really do this, I guess, is to, right when you get carriers, you just start pumping carriers. So, you basically brace yourself to be able to make carriers, and you're going to want a lot of them. Templars are also really good if you have the micro to keep up, but at this time, like, I'm not doing too well, so got no micro in that department. Oh!
This is Hierarch Artanis, commanding the Shield of Iron. Our matrix fields are within range.
Oh,
engaging mass recall.
Now that we have this, we have pretty much our final army.
My brethren, hear me, for there is little time left. All that remains of our race, our civilization, are those that stand beside you now.
Oh, lots of storms
trust
going on.
Strike as one will. Let our last stand burn a memory so bright, we will be remembered forever. Entaro
yes,
Tassadar!
Entaro Adun. Entaro Adun, man. So we should be able to do this. Like, I see no reason why not, because we only need to kill 5 more. Yeah!
If only
oh, no.
We had acted sooner.
Zeratul died again? Like, I always keep him in a good area. It's all good.
Foolish, prideful children. There was one among you who could have jeopardized my great plan. But in your recklessness, you mistook her for the true threat.
So, looks like the... looks like Kerrigan is basically the key to defeating the, not the Zerg particularly, but the problem with the world. And that the Protoss-Zerg hybrid is basically controlling the Zerg and whatnot. But as we're pretty much dead here, and I lost Zeratul, which is kind of a pain in the butt, we're gonna try and at least go sneak up and kill that, other Ultralisk thing. I'm gonna let these guys pretty much just waver on into my base and destroy everything while I kinda go in and make quick work of all my the rest of my units. Whoa! Holy crap. Well, those stalkers are dead. Or maybe not. Wow, they keep coming in. Oh shit. No, kill that one. Kill him! Fight, probes! Fight for your right to mine! Okay, that's the first time I saw Banelings in this level. I see no additional Ultralisk here, though, so... Oh my god. Just a lot of...
My harbingers will usher in a new age.
Just lost a lot of units at once.
Okay.
I return to the void.
Okay, now we should check here if this last one is still alive. Hey, they kind of move around these pedestal things. Oh, what the hell is that? The hell is that?
March boldly without fear.
Forgive me, great Tassadar.
Hey, mothership.
I wasn't.
Learn how to move. Use that as your escape tool. Man, if there was, imagine there was still that Ultralisk here and it had like full HP, I would be screwed right now. So pretty much gonna have to just survive with the single mothership. The single mothership that survived. Now what you can do. So I guess mass recall.
There's just too many of them.
Oh, I'm the Vortex Master. Vortex myself. Oh. Motherships are immune to Vortex. No.
Kerrigan. How could we have known?
So it looks like... Oh, what? What? What's this? Kill 250 additional and 750 additional? That's the only achievements? Whatever, man. I could have done that. I just like kind of like gave it away. But yeah, if you want to do it, basically all you need to do is defend early. And yeah, basically playing through that once and then play it again, you'll pretty much be okay as long as you defend in the key areas. specifically right when the archive is about to get down, you just defend right up before the ramp, then yeah, you should be okay.
Friend Raynor, you now bear witness to the truth. There is a malevolent presence within the void that seeks to destroy everything we hold dear. Could this fallen one be Azel Naga? After so long, could the gods themselves seek our destruction? And Kerrigan, I can hardly believe the wretched Queen of Blades will prevent the destruction of all that we know. Raynor, you may soon hold Kerrigan's fate in your hands. I know only that she must live. Be wary, old friend. The Hounds of the Void are on the hunt.
So, according to Kerrigan, I mean, Zeratul, we are to keep safe Kerrigan, make sure she's safe, and yeah, looks like there's more news. Let's go check that out.
Hankering for some down-home cooking out there in the space lanes? Come on down to Bubba's Gas and Grill. We got Two for Tuesdays, featuring barbecue muta wings. Also, free plasma charge with each fill up. Bubba's Gas and Grub, your space trucker home away from home.
Okay, that was a complete waste of time. Now, why are we able to still hit this? I'm going to take the risk in doing this in one part. Just to see if there's any, it looks like there's no other missions. Raynor's here, though.
That's it. Gonna have to start pretending like I'm working. I should go for a walk outside. Oh, wait. Time for a bold, unstoppable plan. Home, sweet home. Ah, I like all the pretty lights. I'm getting too damn old for this. This old crate needs an overhaul. Standing around talking to my damn self. What the hell was I doing? Revolution's a little slow today. What the hell was I doing?
Well, he has a lot of lines.
I'm getting too damn old for this.
Bit. Let's get some credits. Wow, that's a lot of credits. Credits. Let's go to the armory, shall we? Not sure if we can get anything new, but we can definitely get some upgrades. Now, regarding the upgrades, that would be helpful. Thinking about what to get here, as we pretty much got like everything, but that would actually be pretty helpful too. The reason I got those two upgrades is basically because you can basically just have your units kind of defending and not worry about them too much. Look at those Spider-Mans fight each other. And that's those two upgrades basically support being lazy and lower APM. Although my APM is actually pretty good, but you know, once you get rusty like I am, like I haven't played multiplayer in literally over 2 months, maybe. Yeah, I don't know why, but
you look shaken, sir. What's wrong? Zeratul called it a vision of the future. It was the end times, Matt. Armageddon. More Protoss than we ever knew existed. But there still weren't enough to stop the hybrid.
But what about Kerrigan? Wasn't she supposed to stop them?
In this timeline, she was dead. Killed by us. That's what Zeratul's been trying to tell us all along. She has to live, or we're all doomed.
Yeah, that's right. So anyway, stay tuned for the next episode of StarCraft 2, which hopefully should be coming out pretty soon. I've been having some issues recording lately, and before that I was having issues uploading, so I think I know why I'm getting issues uploading, but I'm not sure yet. And the recording part, I definitely know. So anyway, stay tuned and peace out.